Clark.
A private business number 15, adjourn debate on motion of the Honourable T.A. Franks.
Call the Honourable Burke.
Thank you, Mr. President. I rise to support this motion because the last months have proven to be challenging for everyone, but has also highlighted the importance of strong communities. Our community spirit between neighbours, volunteers and not-for-profit organisations has kept our state strong in the face of adversity. However, does the Liberal government agree with this perception? After the decision to switch off community television on June 30 this year, many feel the Liberal government do not value community services in our community. And for the Channel 44 here in Adelaide, this decision will be detrimental. For over 15 years, Channel 44 has been providing an essential community service for many South Australians. Whether you are part of the arts, love local sport, or just interested in learning more about stick insects, as I have discovered with my children, there are stories for everyone on Channel 44. And when they are really desperate for talent, they will call out for talent from politicians. Our Time, a segment on Channel 44 with Malcolm and Janice, is in its eighth year of production, and I had the pleasure of meeting Malcolm and Janice last year. Their enthusiasm for the platform community television provides is infectious, but their segment is far from a two-person show. When you arrive at the station, you are greeted by a team of volunteers who have given up their night at home. They do this because they not only believe, but they see the benefits of giving voice to the community, to share their stories, stories that would otherwise not be told. Channel 44 has given the state with an alternative to the mainstream and at times sensationalised stories, championing everyday South Australians and giving voice to those who would usually be sidelined by the larger broadcasters. Channel 44 has become one of the few places where the little stories that are so important to our communities are shared and given the time and significance they deserve. Much like community newspapers, where I used to work, Channel 44 provides an essential, localised and relatable perspective. I have seen firsthand the love, care and passion that Channel 44 volunteers pour into their programming. The station is mostly run by a large group of hard-working volunteers who believe wholeheartedly in the service they provide to the community. Allowing students to gain important skills and experience in journalism and broadcasting, community television like Channel 44 has given a leg up to so many new journalists in our community. With social distancing and restrictions, Channel 44 has also been there for South Australians. Stories have been beamed into households to connect people to the community. For the large group of South Australian Greek community, not being able to attend their usual Greek Easter church services earlier this year would have been devastating for many. Thankfully, and due to the work of Channel 44 and the member for West Torrens, the Honourable Tom Koussantonis, the Easter service was broadcast live to thousands of thousands celebrating Greek Easter and could keep this tradition and important calendar date alive. This is just one example that shows how important it is that Channel 44 remain just that, a television channel. I would like to thank the Honourable Tammy Franks for introducing this motion into the State Parliament and the member for Badco from the other place, Jane Stinson. I'd also like to thank my friend Amanda Rishworth, the federal member for Kingston, and other federal Labor colleagues who have championed and are fighting for our local essential community services like Channel 44. The Liberal government still does not have a planned alternative use for the broadcast spectrum that community television stations like Channel 44 occupy. To put simply, it would be a shame and a waste to all South Australians to have their community stations switched off, and even worse, to be switched off with no specific reason. Now more than ever, we need to protect our essential community services. It is the strength of our community bonds that has kept South Australia close while social distancing restrictions have been in place. And when we look back on our state's history, the sharing of these little stories will not seem so little anymore. They will and have become the backbone and the fabric of our communities and the state's vibrant and diverse history. Premier Stephen Marshall likes to talk about his involvement and connection with the National Cabinet, though it appears he has not been able to represent and protect our essential services like this station. Labor will not be supporting the state government's amendments they have tabled. We support the acknowledgement of the hard work of volunteers at Channel 44. However, we do not support erasing important sections of this motion. The June 30 deadline is quickly looming and action is needed now. As we have seen across the country, with only two community television channels remaining, once the community station goes, you can't just flick the on-air light back on easily. We support this motion.
Call the Honourable Mr Pengello.
Thank you, Mr President, and I rise to speak in strong support of the motion by the Honourable Tammy Franks, and I thank her for bringing this important community service facing cruel extinction at the end of the month to the attention of the Parliament. Allow me to roll off a few names, Mr President. Hamish and Andy, Rove McManus, Peter Hellier, Waleed Ali, Tommy Little, Sam Mack, Georgie Coughlin, Dave Hughes, Dave Thornton, Dilruk Jayashinya. You might have heard of them. National TV and Arts Identities. Rove has won three Gold Logies, Waleed Ali and Hamish Blake won each. Dilruk, a comedian who appeared on Channel 10's I'm a Celebrity, has won a Logie for Most Popular New Talent. Mr President, to get there, they had to start from somewhere to learn the ropes in TV production and presentation, because you're not going to get to that sort of you're not going to get that sort of training from the big free-to-air networks. One of the best breeding grounds for broadcast talent is community television. This is where all those celebrities got their start. As someone who has spent more than a quarter of a century working and producing in television, I can appreciate the significant part CTV plays in developing the variety of skills required in broadcasting. It provides practical learning pathways, experiences and opportunities for those in the creative arts and graduates. There's the potential to unearth another Scott Hicks or Kate Blanchett. Community television public broadcasting is also an inexpensive conduit for so many others in our community to have a platform that would not exist anywhere else, particularly on the free-to-air networks. There are 1,500 volunteers who work in this cottage industry, making content in more than 30 languages. One of those content producers is in Adelaide is Jethro Heller, who won an Antenna Award in 2019 for his factual series Tales of a City. Now, allow me to read out a portion of an email I received from Jethro about his 10 years in community TV. And I quote, "Community television offered me the opportunity to reach a larger audience than my shows had previously attracted whilst broadcast on Foxtel. During the last 10 years, I have had the chance to provide practical experience and paid work to dozens of young emerging filmmakers and technicians, many of whom have gone on to produce their own work and begin their careers as filmmakers and journalists. I receive hundreds of messages and emails from members of the public expressing their gratitude that these stories are being broadcast, which are largely overlooked by mainstream media. Community television gives voice to the voiceless, gives recognition to the unsung, and provides an oasis for those that feel they have not been heard or represented. But if community television is switched off, that training ground stops. There will be no studios for them to learn how to operate camera, sound, or on-camera skills. There will be no experience gained by learning the art of editing, script writing, or lighting. Gone will be the stories of culture, of underrepresented segments of society, as well as the events in social history that are recorded for posterity. The people who participate in community TV deserve better than to be simply silenced on the free-to-air landscape and relegated to be lost among the millions of global YouTube video channels. A large percentage of our audience does not have a computer or even a smart TV and could sometimes be described as not very tech savvy. I have personally appealed to Minister Fletcher with over 40 video messages to him via social media, as his office does not respond to emails or calls. End of quote. Thank you, Jethro. If there is a medium that so encapsulates our diverse multicultural society, it is community television, which broadcasts 220 hours of locally made content every week on Channel 31 in Melbourne and Channel 44 in Adelaide. They are the last two standing since 2014, when the then Communications Minister, Malcolm Turnbull, announced that the five Metro CTV station licences would not be renewed beyond 2015 because the Commonwealth required the spectrum it was broadcast on for other unspecified communications purposes. In 2015, the federal government supplied $215,000 to the five stations at the time to set up an online streaming platform. However, it failed to generate much alternative revenue in comparison to the combined $3.4 million they'd been getting. The self-funded sector was placed on a lifeline dependent on the federal government granting it extensions. In 2017, when I was working with Senator Nick Xenophon, Nick secured a six-month extension during the torrid negotiations on the Media Reform Bill. A further two-year extension until 2020 was given. With all the uncertainty surrounding CTV's future and falls in revenue, it resulted in stations in Perth, Brisbane and Sydney folding. However, while Melbourne and Adelaide have managed to weather the economic challenges, revenues have been shrinking because of the destabilising effect of the decision to shut them down as having. It would be naive for anyone in government to suggest they could compete with the plethora of streaming services now available, many of which have vast amounts of investor and subscriber capital and content that is very expensive to produce. They are not-for-profit, CTV, are not-for-profit and operate on the smell of an oily rag with revenues of around $2.5 million that are generated from sponsorships and partnerships. They have never been a financial burden on the federal government and were profitable until they had their license renewals taken away. CTV accommodates 140 internships each year sourced from diverse cultural backgrounds. It broadcasts 11 programs per week produced as part of tertiary institution coursework in the film and TV and journalism degrees. Mr. President, Channel 31 has a long-running partnership with the National Ethnic Multicultural Broadcaster Council to produce the Multicultural AFL show, which is produced by young people from multicultural and multi-faith backgrounds. Their Community Builder program creates content that focuses on minority, disability, health, multicultural, youth and environmental causes. Channel 44 provided coverage of the Fringe Parade, the Dream Big Festival and the Cabaret Festival. Mr. President, who will do that once it's gone? Mr. President, I'll share with you some statistical figures which will come as a surprise to many, including me. 90% content is produced in Australia. Since the COVID-19 lockdown in March, Channel 31 in Melbourne had a 23% increase in viewers, or 150,000 new sets of eyes. In Adelaide, it was a 27% rise with an additional 57,000 viewers. Austam data shows in April 1 million Australians watched community TV. Between February and April this year, it competed and regularly beat free-to-air networks including ABC Me, ABC News, 7 Flicks, 9 Life, 10 Peach, SBS Viceland, SBS Food, NITV, SBS World Movies. During the COVID-19 lockdown, both channels broadcast live Easter Roman Catholic and Greek Orthodox services and a Ramadan TV daily program for the Islamic community. Mr. President, this is what community television does. It brings communities together and it builds bridges. I strongly commend this motion to the Legislative Council.
Just the Honourable Mr. Pangello, you need to just move your amendment. Move the amendment standing in your name.
Thank you, Mr. President. And Mr. President, I would also like to move the amendment in my name after paragraph 5 to insert new paragraph as follows. 6 requests the President of the Legislative Council to write to the Federal Minister for Communications, Cyber Safety and the Arts conveying this resolution. Thank you.
The Honourable Mr. No, you want to make a contribution, I believe. Someone has seconded the amendment. Seconded. The Honourable Mr. No.
Thank you, Mr. President. I also rise today to speak in favour of this motion. Firstly, I'd like to thank the Honourable Ms. Tammy Franks for bringing this motion to the House and also raising awareness of the plight of the Channel 44. Channel 44 has been sending television content into our community for over a quarter of a century, broadcasting via free-to-air television signal and digitally through its online platform. It is our state's only community television broadcaster. In fact, I believe it is one of only 2 community television stations in Australia. The other is Channel 31 in Melbourne. Channel 44 is not profit and I understand provides its community service without funding from taxpayers. It enables people to develop skills in production, presentation and broadcasting, areas where limited opportunities exist in a state of our size. Channel 44 gives our community opportunities to express ourselves, to reflect on who we are, showcase local events and share our stories and contents. Furthermore, during the coronavirus pandemic restrictions, community television brought people together in ways that were unanticipated and unexpected. I understand as part of celebrations over Easter, Ramadan and Vaisakhi, Channel 44 and 31 filled a void and provided an opportunity community service. When people were unable to attend places of worship, the station helped them feel connected and enabled them to practice faith by broadcasting multi-dimensional services. Mr. President, although many in the community enjoy streaming digital content, we must remember those who are unfamiliar with this medium and still relied on free-to-air. For these people, the local information and community service provided by Channel 44 can only be delivered via its broadcasting signal. Despite all its work, its good work, as this financial year closes, Channel 44 free-to-air signal will cease reducing access to local television contents. It seems we have been here before when the station stared down the SAM dilemma in 2017. That time the federal government seeing sense to extend the Channel 44's broadcasting licence. From what I can gather, the station has no insight as to what their broadcasting signal is needed for or why they will no longer be able to use it. It seems the federal Liberal Coalition's government believe white noise is better than hearing our local voices speak. I lend my voice to argue that avenues should exist for both the community having access to participate in the experience of television production and broadcasting, and to be able to access community broadcasting and local content. With that, Mr. President, I commend the motion to the Chamber, and I urge the Federal Minister to approve ongoing to-air broadcasting for Channel 44 and Melbourne's Channel 31.
Thank you, Mr. President. I rise to speak on the motion moved by the Honourable Tammy Franks about Community Television Channel 44 on behalf of the Government. I would like to take this opportunity to thank the mover and acknowledge her passion and work in this area and the broader arts and cultural sector. The Honourable Member's motion seeks to bring to the attention of the Council that the future of Channel 44 is facing uncertainties and challenges since they were informed by the Commonwealth Government in September 2014 that their licence would not be extended beyond 30 June 2020. There is no doubt in any of the Honourable Member's mind today that it is important that we acknowledge and congratulate Adelaide's community TV media broadcaster Channel 44 for covering South Australian stories, social and cultural activities, showcasing talent and creating employment and hands-on training opportunities for the local screen sector for the past 15 years, as mentioned by many Honourable Members today. I have personally witnessed the good work for Channel 44 on a number of occasions, particularly their enthusiastic coverage on the Lunar New Year Street Party for Chinatown Adelaide and other significant multicultural events around South Australia in the last 15 years. As we all know, in the telecommunication and media business, there is more competition, more innovation and more dynamic online interactions, which have drastically changed the way consumers and the public accessing contents compared to 10 or 15 years ago. During the coronavirus pandemic, we would have observed that our community members rely heavily on digital distribution platform and using the internet to broadcast contents and get timely information and stay connected with each other. In September 2014, all Australian community television programs were informed by the then Communication Minister, the Honourable Malcolm Turnbull, that community television transmitter licences were to expire at the end of 2014. In view of the concerns raised after the announcement and to allow community television sector more time to prepare an alternative transition plan, the Commonwealth Government then extended all licences by another 12 months to 31st of December 2015. The advice I have received is that the federal government had worked with the community television sector and the Community Broadcasting Foundation to consider the most appropriate transition strategy for services to migrate online by the end of 2015. Since then, out of the five mainland capital cities that have community television channels, Western Australia, New South Wales and Queensland all move off the spectrum, with South Australia and Victoria licences concluding on the 30th of June 2020. With community television known as the sixth channel spectrum and due to increasing amount of competition and innovation in telecommunications, the Australian Government announced a spectrum review to carefully examine future prospects. And due to the evolution of the telecommunications and viewers' behaviour, many Australians are increasingly turning to access content that doesn't require a spectrum, such as internet services like Netflix or on-demand programs. This has encouraged the government to refocus their vision and recast the current broadcasting spectrum policy framework and develop a strategy that fits the next wave of innovation. The current serving Federal Minister for Communications, the Honourable Paul Fletcher, has been working extensively with the community television sector over the last couple of years to develop a clear transition path and to assist those working in the industry. In addition to the support given by the Australian Government, the Premier of South Australia has contacted Minister Fletcher to discuss the issue at hand. The Premier, who is passionate about the arts and media sector, has advocated for an extension to be given on behalf of Channel 44. However, the federal minister unfortunately has made it clear that another extension will not be granted. With the history and the background about the federal government's changes in broadcasting, I would therefore like to amend the terms of the motion as follows in my name. Yes, I'll be moving my motion in my name, Mr. President.
Read it out.
We leave out paragraph 2 to 5 and insert the following new paragraphs as follows. Notes the Commonwealth Government advised community television stations they would lose access to the 6th broadcast spectrum in 2014 and has provided support to community television stations to transition to online platforms. 3.3 notes the Premier, the Honourable Stephen Marshall, has advocated for the Commonwealth Government to extend Channel 44 use of the spectrum. And 4, thanks Channel 44 staff and all its volunteers for their exceptional service to South Australia through their local and culturally diverse content.
Seconded.
Thank you, Mr. President. So on this point, we would like to acknowledge that there will be disappointment in the community and would like to take this opportunity to recognise the advocacy and hard work of all the employees, supporters and volunteers behind Channel 44 since its launch in 2004. Working as a launching pad for many media personalities and creative industry experts, Channel 44 has nurtured and given a visual platform to tell South Australian stories and inspire many enthusiastic young talents to undertake a career in creative industries. Over the last 15 years, there has been an amazing network of individuals who have contributed and supported the delivery of community free-to-air television. No doubt, during the COVID-19 period, some of the religious and multicultural organisations turned to Channel 44 to connect with their community. It was reported that CTV stations in Adelaide and Melbourne achieved historical Easter live-to-air broadcasts. These initiatives ought to be congratulated, and I acknowledge and thank the leadership team of Channel 44 for their ongoing commitment and valuable service they have provided the South Australian community. But at the same time, many groups in the multicultural sector during pandemic have also access to internet services, were readily connected to their religious and cultural groups through digital means, such as Facebook Live and other social media platforms. The Minister for Communication, Cyber Safety and the Arts had recently confirmed that since 2014, the radio frequency spectrum that was historically made available to community television stations in 5 largest cities in Australia should be put to alternative uses. The federal government emphasised that community television will continue to have an important future and will continue to be a place where members of the community can make television content, but instead of using the traditional spectrum, there is now the capacity for community groups to generate and disseminate those rich contents using online platforms. We'd like to highlight how some of the best Australian new talents who have creatively produced new contents online. For example, on YouTube, Natalie Tran, of a Vietnamese background, who is an Australian online producer, actress, comedian, and has over 1.8 million subscribers. She has been described by her fans as charming, quirky, and hilarious. This has been successfully delivered online. In South Australia, we have the South Sudanese refugee Gabrielle Atkon, who has established a Playback 808 online record label. He and his fellow artists are making a difference through hip-hop music online. And he received Best Male Artist at the 2017 SA Music Awards and was also received a Youth Award at the Governor's Multicultural Awards. I seek leave to move the progress to report to be extended.
Seek leave to conclude your remarks. Is leave granted? Leave's granted.
No, I'm just having one.
Hang on. We've got 4 different people giving instructions here at the moment. Have you got 1 minute to go? Is that what you're saying? So could we not let her conclude before... Okay. So you've sought leave to conclude. The Honourable Ms. Franks, you would say on motion?
On motion.
On motion? Seconded. Put the question. Those questions say aye against. Say no. It's carried. Treasurer.
Mr. President, I move that standing orders be so far suspended as to enable the sitting of the Council to be extended beyond 6:30 p.m. in order that business of the day may be concluded.
Seconded. Put the question. Those questions say aye against. Say no. The ayes have it.
Honourable Member, can I move the notice of whatever it is, private member's business number, adjourned on motion, be taken into consideration forthwith?
Honourable Ms. Lee.
Thank you, Mr. President. So there are people like Natalie Tran and Gabrielle Akon who can be very successful in generating original creative content and disseminating it online, and that's certainly where we will see more and more of where community television will go. The federal government has a policy to provide funding in those new online directions, and community television sectors should seek further opportunities with the federal government. In closing, I hope honourable members will consider the amendments I'm moving for this motion and once again express the government's appreciation and thank Channel 44 for its dedicated services and contributions over the last 15 years to the South Australian community. We acknowledge the great work and commitment of all employees, volunteers, content creators and viewers on their contribution and support to community TV and wish them well in their future endeavours.
Ms. Franks.
And I thank those speakers who have made a contribution, the Honourable Tung Ngo, the Honourable Jeng Lee, the Honourable Frank Pangello and the Honourable Emily Burke. And I also note the contribution of the Member for Bagco, the Federal Member for Mayo, Rebecca Sharkey, the Member for Kingston, Amanda Rishworth, the Senator for South Australia, both Marielle Smith and Penny Wong, as well as many others who have seen strong support for community TV here in South Australia and in Victoria, the only two states where it is now left. We know that the spectrum will be lost to community TV in just 13 short days. We also know that since I introduced this motion that we've seen the Senate pass unopposed a motion calling for the minister to extend the licences of our last surviving community broadcasters. Our own station here in South Australia, Adelaide's Channel 44, is fighting for survival. It is looking for stability. It's been given 6 years of stop-start, unstable offers that have not allowed them to set up and keep the sustainability that they need, that will indeed endanger their contracts with various academic and other institutions when they, to no apparent reason, denied access to the spectrum. Back when Minister Turnbull made this decision, he said he had other uses. Well, we've yet to hear any other use put forward from the current federal minister. Yet with a stroke of a pen, we're going to lose a substantial conglomeration of community talent, opportunity and expertise. And I do know Jethro Hull, and I do know Jethro, who has sent the 40 video, Heller, who's sent the 40 video messages to the minister, because as he was quoted by the Honourable Frank Pangello, does not answer other forms of messages. And I urge the Premier perhaps to try TikTok. Maybe if the phone calls didn't work and the pleadings and the letters, perhaps TikTok or Instagram video, because that's all that will be left to South Australians in the screen industry at the local community level. You're telling them to go to Facebook and to use the digital world when you're withdrawing the spectrum at no cost to the South Australian taxpayer, but significant cost to the South Australian community. In this era, the digital era and the screen era, we should be investing in pathways into these industries and connections that are local in this global village in which we live. We should be keeping community television strong and stable and supported and celebrating it having a long and fruitful future, rather than mourning the fact it's only got 13 days to go. I do support the Honourable Frank Pangallo's amendment to the motion, and in addition to a letter from the President of the Legislative Council, I do hope that TikTok from the Premier might be on its way to the Minister. And I will indicate to the government that, given their amendments seek to replace my original motion's provisions, I cannot support them. I find it offensive that you would replace the motion with one of your own that mourns the loss of community television instead of stands up and fights for community television in South Australia.
I will put the Honourable Ms Lee's amendment that paragraphs 2 to 5 is proposed to struck out by the I'll put the question that the existing paragraphs stand. Those for the question say aye.
Aye.
Against say no. The ayes have it. Okay. The new paragraph 6 is as proposed to be inserted by the Honourable Frank Pangallo be so inserted. Those for the question say aye.
Aye.
Against say no. The ayes have it. The question is that the motion moved by the Honourable T.A. Franks and as amended by the Honourable F. Pangallo be agreed to. Those for the question say aye.
Aye.
Against say no. The ayes have it.